Get it in, boy.
Right, we've got to him. Short hooked up right when we see the Marco swim past the boat.
First fish for Shawnee's new Stella, and it's singing to him. Yeah, I'm bit too. And there goes your triple hookup, boys.
Yeah, boys.
It's a three-way.
Well, it's been a while since I've been out on the water. Far too long, in fact. And today, it is a winter fishing mission. Kingfish and snapper are the target. And as usual, we've loaded up the tank with live baits, which are good for both snapper and kingfish. And we're going to be mechanical jigging for some kingfish and slow jigging for snapper, because we have got some brand spanking new lures to try out today. And Shaw is just keen as. He's gonna jig all day, or so he reckons.
Stand by.
All right, captain's put us on the spot. Just waiting for the all clear to drop. So
yeah, okay.
There it is. There it is. So yeah, out here doing a bit of jigging today. Gonna hopefully, fingers crossed, pick up a few kingfish. See how that goes, and then later on in the day, I think the old boy's keen to have a flick over the mud with some slow jigs. Try pick up maybe some snapper, John Dory. Don't want to get too far ahead, just focus on the kingfish at the moment. All go, eh?
Yeah. Yeah, we're on good sign. Good sign.
I don't remember this being this tiring, eh?
Who are you going to jig all day, mate?
I will. I'm just a bit knackered.
That's why you're easy pebble, mate. You can go all day with those. There's a shark here, boy.
Yep, got him. Yeah, boy, that's a good one.
So Shaw's hooked up right when we see the Marco swim past the boat.
Get it in, boy!
Right, I'm going back to him.
It's a good one. Is there a shark there?
Yeah, there's a shark right here.
Oh.
So you want the good news or the bad news?
Bad news.
The bad news is there's a Marco right here.
Yeah.
The good news is it's probably smaller than your kingy.
Oh, hey.
Yeah, it's a little wee one. He'll see, he might have a go at it though. Look at him. He's looking at our underwater lights.
Oh, little dude.
Look at him. Hey, little dude. He loves underwater lights. Here he is.
He's playing right at the outboard. You know, he's coming to the camera, look.
Oh, I don't remember this being so hard, eh?
You got big muscles now.
No, I don't.
You've been going to the gym.
It doesn't help. And my back's sore. Look.
What do you mean, you...
Get the camera away.
It's just how we like it. We like our Marcos small and our kingy's big. I want to see if the kingy eats the Marco or the other way around. Oh yeah, mate. It's a fatty.
All right.
Good boy.
That's me done for the day.
That's you done for the day. I thought you said you were going to jig all day.
I was kidding.
It's a fat one.
Solid.
What do you want to do with it?
I'll keep that one, eh?
Yeah, we'll keep him. Oh, we're going to keep him. We'll give him the icky.
Japan!
Oh, good shot.
Beauty. Right, I'll get a photo for you, boy.
Yep. On the drop. Getting peeled. I was quite high up, eh?
Oh, you can see them on the screen where they were, was following your jig.
I wonder if I got shark.
Really?
Yep, shark.
Bring him on down here, mate. We're going to go to another spot.
That's it.
You want the good news or the bad news?
I'll take the good news.
Good news is you got half a kingfish.
What's the bad news?
You got half a kingfish. We'll better cut and save some meat on that. But that means we're moving to a different spot. As soon as that happens, you got to move. Like, guys will stay on the spot, throwing back kingfish heads, not coming off their bag limit, thinking that they'll be able to get a kingfish in. As soon as this happens, leave. Because what it does is it trains the sharks that there's easy food here. And if everybody did the same, sharks would move off a lot of the popular kingy reefs. Fortunately, I've got quite a few spots around here and we'll just move to one. But if the sharks turn up at that one, we'll move on again.
Right, well, the old boys found some better sign, so see if we can all get hooked up here.
Jinkies.
Got him. Good boy.
Oh yeah, boy.
This will be a first kingy for his Stella as well. First fish for Shawnee's new Stella. And it's singing to him. Oh, I'm getting bit too. Yeah, I'm bit as well. Double hookup time. So well, there you go. You'd be tempted. I mean, we've got a couple of kingfish. Well, we've got 1.5 kingfish at the last spot. You'd be tempted to try again, but we've moved probably half a mile. Uh-oh, speaking of sharks, they might be here as well. Either that kingfish woke up or it, or it could have got, hopefully there's not sharks here as well. I was just going to say, we moved and found more kingfish, but there might be more sharks as well. Unless this thing's bigger than I thought it was. I can see more kingies on the TV there. See those marks, solid marks coming through? There were more kingfish.
Yeah.
Is that a good one, Sean? Feels all right? We've got a kingfish and it's whole. A whole kingfish, fancy that.
Oh, what's behind it? Shark behind it.
And really?
Yeah, and it swam back down to Sean's.
How sweet.
that's a nice one.
Yeah, nothing wrong with that. On the circle hook. Fatty, eh? Look how fatty he is.
Another nice one.
I'll release this. Right, straight over to Shawnee's. You've got a whole one. Looks like a whole kingfish, mate. It's not a baddie to bust, break your Stella in, mate. Oh, you got a short leader. What are you doing to me?
Yeah, there, mate.
Another fat one.
Yeah, then, you're in good nick. Been feeding on the squid, I'd say. Oh, yeah, well done, mate. Chuck your rod in there, mate. We'll get a photo for you. Oh, you got the hunting, you're all branded too. Oh, Shimano and hunting and fishing. You're looking for a job. On the easy pebble. Easy to hook them. There's no guarantees about them being easy to wind in once you hook them. Yew! Yeah.
Oh, we've had a couple of hookups, had a double. Just need to get the triple now.
Yeah, we're marking a couple now in 70. Yeah, this fish in 70.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I got hit on the drop.
All right. Yep, got him. Yep, you got him.
We on.
We're marking good, marking real good here.
Oh, that sounds
stop
good.
Stop him, mate.
That sounds stop good.
Stop him. Stop him.
Oh. Yep.
You got him on, Sean?
Yep, got him.
Good big boy. Good boy. Right. That's the jigs both hooked up. See if they like the livey as well.
Where's the triple? Oh, I got some tight drag on that bitch.
My bait's getting excited. Yeah, I'm bit too.
Yeah, boy.
And there goes your triple hookup, boys.
Triple
hookup, boys. Yeah. Yeah, the boys. It's a three-way. Well, I'm on here, obviously. Shawnee's on here first to hook up on the drop. So jigs and live baits, different sorts of jigs. So the pebble stick, Sean's using the normal Shimano pebble stick. Oh, Sean's on the easy pebble. I'm on the live bait, but mate, if there's any credit, it's really just the Wasp picked them up on my port side scan. On the Wasp, went over the top of them on the Furuno and I said to the boys, get ready. And this is why I said get ready. We're marking them. Oh man, there's a massive school there.
I've just got a rat.
Yeah, they'll be following these ones we got hooked up. There's a big school under us. Man.
Oh, what the?
You lose yours?
Sharky.
You got sharks?
Sharky.
Oh no, there's sharks here too, bugger.
Far out.
No, no, no. The spot was looking so good, we're going to have to leave it, boys.
No.
Yours might be whole. Go hard, bro. Don't eat mine. Don't eat mine. Huss him in, bro.
Nice one. That's a good fish.
Huss him in. Grab him, Sean. Just grab him by the mouth. Get him out of the water.
Yeah, boy.
Chaos. Yours whole.
It's
whole.
You guys are lucky. Ooh. Come here.
Good boy. Thank you. Oh, yeah, it's a nicey. Oh, yeah, it's fatty too. Yeah, that's a nice fatty. And then there's...
Yeah!
Three-way. Oh, well, let these buggers go. We're going to have to go find another spot. Winter, man. Sharks. Even this time of year. We'll get... synchronize. You. Yeah, we're on good sign. Stand by.
All right, so captain's put us on the spot. Just waiting for the all clear before we drop. Just running with this 350-gram pink Lumo pebble stick. So it's one of Dad's favourites, but we'll put it to the test and see how it actually goes. Yep, yep, yep. Big, big, big.
Big, eh?
Big.
What do you think, it's big?
I think it might be big.
You get him, my son. Yes, I'm bit as well.
It feels heavy, eh? It's just not running. Never mind, it's running. I lied, it's running.
Yeah, I got him on.
Yeah, boy.
You distract the shark for me, Shaw.
No, you do it.
Hopefully there's none here. Oh, you got some load on there, my boy.
Yeah, brother. Yeah.
That's some load on there, bae. If we get sharked at this spot, we're going snapper fishing. Got it away from the reef. I mean, once upon a time, once you got your kingfish away from the reef, you could relax. Now you've got to get it away from the reef and then get it away from the sharks.
I'm already over this, eh?
You say you're already over it?
No, I'm kidding.
Oh, I might have just been sharked then. Oh no, he's whole. I've got a whole one. It's a good sign. Don't hook yourself.
Got him? Good work.
Phew! That's my little one. Let's go and see if Shaw's getting on with this giant. I tried to decoy the sharks away from you, mate. Don't leave that thing in the water, mate. The sharks will get it. Keep it moving.
I got colour.
Yep. These kingfisher spawning at the moment, so they're fat. This one's a male. Yeah, we'll let him go and do his thing. Is it still kicking, Shaw?
Yeah, bro, it's whole. It's a nice one.
Yeah, it's a nice one. Good one for a young fella. Oh, right. Easy to wait. Easy target. On the original, hey? The old pinkin.
I was saying before to the camera that that's your favourite. Then I'd be testing that theory.
What do you reckon? Is it your favourite now?
I won't give you the satisfaction. It's all right.
It's all right. Yeah. Okay. Well, you can take it off and change it if you want. If you
don't like my... too much hassle.
Oh, he slapped you on the face. Did he get it? He bitch slapped you.
That was a good one.
He bitched you big time.
Oh, that hurt my jaw.
Come on. Get him.
Oh. Oh.
You guys had enough? Let's go get some snappers. First time using these new Rakuchan Baku Bakus. There you go, fellas. That worked for first drop. Don't know what it is, of course. And 105 metres of water. I wonder what it is. I reckon snapper. Uh-oh.
Shark.
Uh-oh. Well, we may not find out what it is because it's been eaten by something bigger. Unless a bass or something's eaten it because it's just swimming off slow. Unless I had a snapper and a bass is eating it. It's kind of what it feels like. Only 25 pound leader, so. I mean, look at this. Be swimming back to its home on the reef.
Yeah.
Be back to its home. Bust it off.
Bugger. I wonder what it was.
I don't know, but I lost my fish and my lure. I reckon it was a nice snapper on the start.
Yeah.
I don't know, probably about a 3 or 4 kilo snapper. Yeah. Got a hundy. Hundy will do. These Rakuchans are essentially the same looking, more or less. Oh, there you go, it's got a bottom line. As the Tiger Baku Baku, and similar to the Lacanus, the main thing that's really cool about them is they're all interchangeable. You don't have to untie your hooks, you can just pull the head off. And Shaw's gonna demonstrate it for you. Because I've never done it. I literally just fished these for the first time.
So you got your slow jig there, and whether you want to change the colour of the head or you're travelling, you don't want, you know, you've got your hooks attached at the bottom, you don't want that head swinging around when you're steaming along. All you have to do is that pin at the top, get a hold of that. As soon as you pull that pin, it stays there. you can pull your slow jig apart, have your skirt there, put a different coloured head on, change the weight while keeping the same skirt, and then it's just a matter of putting it back together, putting that there, this back on top, and then pushing that pin straight back down. It's good to go again.
Nice.
Easy. Bit of a change of plan, change of scene. Arm started giving out a little bit on the old kingfish jigging, so.
Oh, Shaw's hooked up first drop. Sean's got some interest on the live bait, and I'm about to get to the bottom. It's a good sign on the sounder, and just a slow wind back up. Nice one, bud. Dang. From the icky treatment.
Yeah, give that heaps, mate. Don't you got heaps of drip? Oh,
I'm getting bit over here too.
Oh!
Get that camera off me. Yeah, oh, I couldn't wind, I only got away. Bugger.
Weird look. Oh, babe, whatever it is.
Are you looking?
Remember that gimbal, eh?
Oh, lost it.
Bugger. Yup. Another snapper. Snapper.
Oh, here we go. I might have his mate.
They work.
Cause I'm a Ruckle Chan.
He's on.
How far up were you?
Oh, 50, I think.
Oh, Trevally. It's a Trev. Jeez, is there a net? Should stay in. Sweet. Work it. Got him.
You got him, sure?
Yeah, bolt. Feels a little bit heavier. Oh, I love this rod. Here it is. Snapper.
Nice one, mate. Oh, it's a good one. Pink and white, right. Seems to be doing the business, eh?
Yeah, it is.
There we go.
Oh.
Yeah, nice.
Yeah.
Right, we're out here short.
Alright, the fun part. Do you want to take Gus and Gills into your Trevally or don't care?
Well, there you go. It's another good day out. We finished it with a dive. Nice big fat craze, just to complement the kingfish, which we're gonna do is tataki, the loins, which we've got a step-by-step recipe for at ultimatefishing.tv, as well as recipes for crayfish. And probably more interesting to you guys, we've got how-to videos on the mechanical jigging and slow jigging. And so for everything you've seen us do today, we've got step-by-step videos. It's all free to watch. We've just had a bit of a muck around day out, but we're back filming soon, so you can be expecting new content right here for free at ultimatefishing.tv.